First of all, Coach, I have so much love and respect for you and what you do. You know, you care for the kids, care for the community, care about their education, them as people, and that's why you win, and that's why you've had a tremendous success. And anybody's successful, they don't luck your way into it, okay? You don't just happen by luck or chance. You have to know what you want. And that's the question. I don't know what you want. That's between you and your coaches. Coach knows what he got to do for this team. But what I want you to know is you're going to hear a lot of speakers before me and after me. But I really mean what I'm saying. Coach is talking about him being honored. I'm being honored by him letting me inside the locker room, inside and with his team. Guys he loves and cares for. And why do we coach? We coach in all kinds of different ways. Well, what is a coach? I'm going to get into that a little bit here in a second. But I just want you to know how fortunate and how blessed you are to play for him. We've been thrilled for any of my kids to work with him. And you know where he stands. And there's no BS. And the sucker and flat out coach. And with that being said, thank you, Coach. And I appreciate being here. I just want you to know, I'm not what I should be, nor what I could be. But I thank God I'm not what I used to be. Three things, three H's. You got your head, you got your heart, and you got your hands. And people ask me all the time, well, Coach, what do you look for in recruiting? I look for somebody that's doing something that I can't coach. And I can coach a lot of things in this game. But that kid's got to bring something to the table. And when I talk about the three H's and what I look for in a player, I really do. I look to myself, God, I don't want to play against him. If I don't want to coach against you, I'm recruiting you. That simple. But your head is your control tower. Your attitude is so important. Wisdom is the most important. You got knowledge is a collection of data. You got intelligence is ability to reason. And then you got wisdom, putting those two together, and in my opinion, with the Spirit of God with you. I want players with spirit, enthusiasm. Enthusiasm, the Greek word, it means enthros, which means God in us, a spirit, a fire. My daddy had a third grade education, and he taught us to work. You go to work. Work's never killed nobody, Tony. It scared the hell out of everybody, but it's never killed anybody. Go to work. The other thing is your heart. Put your heart in it, guys. Put your heart in it. Go for it. I married my wife not because she's pretty, which she is, not because she's smart, which she is, not because she's got a good personality, which she does. I married her because of the way I felt. She made me want to be a better person. And then I loved her. I didn't know how to define love, but I loved her. I didn't want to let her down. And she was very good to me when I wasn't good to me. She looked for something in me when I didn't see something in me. But if you will put your heart in it, I always thought if I could just die on the floor, maybe they'd name a trophy after me. And that's weird, but I did. I hustled. I don't think I was a good basketball player by any stretch. But far as I know, there's nobody ever out hustling me. Far as I know. And if they did, I'd like to meet him somewhere and see, by gosh, I'm going to come out. Tell you a story about recruiting. I was recruiting Andre Morgan, who ended up being ASUN Player of the Year. And we're in the gym, and this other coach, I'm going to spare the name right now because this is on video, but it's a true story. I have no reason to tell you nothing but the truth. And I'm recruiting this kid, and this coach flew in, and he's over there waiting his turn. I'm talking to the kid. And he said, Coach, in all due respect, I need to go over there and spend some time with that other coach. I said, yeah, that's fine. I said, but here's what I want you to do. I said, I want you to go over there and tell that coach that Coach Engel wants to know if you're willing to stay here Let's just see who will stay here the longest in this gym for you. Now see, here's what I knew that that other coach didn't know. I challenged him and I would die. I don't know how to quit. I have prayed, God, teach me how to quit. I don't know how to quit. If I start something, I finish it. Keep going. And you know what's interesting about that statement? I'm in it. Just like I did when I got my knee tore up in Hudson, Kansas. And I got on the airplane. I'm looking out the window of the airplane. My mother sat by me, she's crying. My girlfriend and my wife now is crying. And you know, it's not cool for a guy your age to be crying. But my dreams were shattered. When I tore my knee up, it just tore all the ligaments out of it. It broke my heart, because I was a sophomore. Now who wants a 5'9", 5'10" guard that can't walk? I crawled on that floor and I knew it was over. I said, it's over. Broke my heart. But when I looked out that tarmac in that window and I saw my daddy cry, and I never saw my daddy cry. I didn't think he loved me. But some wise person once said, you can see more clear through a tear. Could be tears of joy, like I've known, having 5 children and a beautiful wife and winning a lot of games. I've cried tears of joy. And for my players and some of their life experiences, I've cried when I've heard that they walk across the stage, get that degree. Coach, 3:00 in the morning. He mentions his name. So what are you doing? I said, Coach, I just want to call and tell you, it's a girl. I said, really? Him and his wife had a little girl. His mom and dad both dead. He had nobody else to celebrate with. He was the only child, but he called the coach. The other H is your hands. You have hands so you can be lifted up. You are where you are right now and what you are right now because of who you know, who you trust, your talents that God has blessed you with, who believed in you. I know that coach right there. If he didn't believe that you could help win the national championship, if he didn't believe he could help you as a person, you wouldn't be here. Now that's a fact. But we give it our hands to bless other people's lives, okay? We give a phone to let it ring while you're talking. But you're giving your hands to help other people. Okay? That's all I'm saying. You don't have to listen. You don't have to listen to me. You don't have to listen to a word I say. Because more attention people pay to what you do, than what you say. You don't have to listen to me. But I guarantee you one thing, I don't care if your hair lifts Hitler. If you try to win one of these for you, I guarantee you one thing, you will not win it. You will not win it. Only reason I answer this could be my wife. Hold on a second. Keep the camera running. Here's the thing. Right here. Kind of stuff. It takes me a long time to get dressed in the morning. You know? But I didn't win on one of those. We won. We. And I know this team's going through some hard times right now. now. Some players are injured, some things happen. You know, guys get foul trouble, things happen, this, that, da, 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 da. But I also believe that when the dream is big enough, the obstacles are small enough to overcome. And I also believe that crazy things happen. The Lord sort of kicks in, or synchronicity, a law of attraction, call it whatever you want to. Something happens, it all falls in place. And you've heard the saying, there's no I in team. Everybody's heard that, right? Team, together, everyone achieves more. Whoa, I love it. That's awesome. But guess what? There is an I in win. I like to win. There's an I in champion. And I like to be a champion. Now, there's a difference between a winner and a champion. One of the major differences in a winner and a champion is this. A winner knows he's a winner. But you got to go prove he's a champion. The champion knows he's a winner. And he knows he's a champion. Winners participate while champions celebrate. There's nothing wrong with being a winner, guys. There's absolutely nothing wrong with being a winner, if that's the best you can do. And I look at every game we play. And right now, I'm not sure. I think your record's 20 or 19 or something. You run. What's your record?
25, Coach.
20 and 5?
Yes, sir.
20 and 5. In my opinion, I go, they won 20 championships. And they came runner-up 5 times. That's what I look at. I'm not taking anything away from the hard work that you've got and the hard work that you've done. That's what I look at. That's the way I look at it. You're not a loser because you lose. Why would I say that? Because as a basketball coach at BYU, I went 0-19. 0-19. I couldn't win a game at BYU as an interim basketball coach. The head coach got fired. They hired me as interim coach. I didn't want the job. I just stood up for principles that are correct, not, you know, not people that are wrong. I stood up and I said, okay, I'll do it. I don't want to do it. I knew I was committing professional suicide. I would never coach Division I level again. They're going to fire me. It's going to happen. We had 9 freshmen, 5 season-ending injuries, and then to this day, that schedule that year was 14 out of 19 games against national-ranked teams. Nobody cared about that. We just kept getting beat. Didn't matter how close, didn't matter nothing. We went 0-19. And I came home. I came home. My son one time, he said, knock, knock. I said, who's that? He said, Owen. I said, Owen who? He said, you're 0-19, Daddy. And you know, after his reconstructive surgery, it looked pretty good. It looked pretty good right now. But the I is so important, and let me explain why, okay? First of all, you want me a champion? Look them in the eye, and the eyes don't lie. Just look them in the eye. Just look right down the frickin' eye and see what they're made out of, especially when times get tough. And let me say, the truth is in the eyes, cause the eyes don't lie. Amen. Smiling faces. There's a lot of teams in this league and in this country would love to beat y'all. The program the coach has built here is insane, what all he's done, what all he's been able to accomplish. You know, it's unbelievable. One of the top programs in the nation. And you ain't playing for a little flim-flam, you know, league. You're playing in a tough fucking league. And every one of them suckers want to beat you. Isn't that great? Isn't that wonderful? And then you want to just keep improving, keep getting better. And that's all you can do, control what you can. 2 men looked out prison bars. One saw mud, the other saw stars. 2 men are faced with the same circumstance. Exact same circumstance. One man succeeds, why another man fails proves the power is in the man and not the circumstance. So the I, it means I will take responsibility. Now this is very important to me. I will take responsibility for me. Don't worry about the foul shot, I'll knock it down. Don't worry about the steal, I'll get the steal. Don't worry about the pass, you get the freaking ball. Don't worry about effort from me. If the coach ever has one word, now this might blow your mind, but it's the flipping truth. 44 years of coaching, there's one word I never used. I didn't ever use the word. You ready? Hustle. That might blow your mind if you ever saw me play. I'll tell you why I didn't use hustle. Because that's expected. You don't get what you want. Hey, everybody wants a ring. You want a ring? Yeah. You want a ring? Yeah. Want a ring? Want a ring? Everybody wants a ring. But not everybody wants to work. And then expect it. You expect it? That's the champions. That's the champions. Expect it. Walk in the gym, and every one of you have been somebody's hero. Everybody in this room has been somebody's hero. All these guys on the couch, I don't know their history. I know some of them, but they don't know to say hero, but they ain't gonna say that right now. But here's the point. But here's the point. You are somebody's hero. Could be just a little kid in your neighborhood. It might be somebody that you play street ball with, or community ball with. They want to be just like you. They could probably tell you the day that you said, hey, everybody ain't here. We'll take little man. Come on, get in here with us, little man. Golly. You get to go out there and be with them. Don't ever forget that, guys. Somebody was your hero. And now you're their hero. And don't be a zero. And see, a friend, see, here's what I teach. I give out scholarships, okay? We play with sportsmanship. We win championships. You got that? Did you zero in? Pretty good. Championship. Boom. But the most important ship, and it'll never sink. Hear me now. It's not relationships. There's people that are biologically related and they have nothing. In my opinion, philosophy is friendship. Friendship is the only ship I know that'll never sink. A true friendship. And I believe there's a lot of people knows that I'm their friend. I really believe that. So with your team, okay? Hey, cuz, it's two better than one, okay? Two better than one? No! One, two's better than one only when they work as one. You ever heard a thing called divorce? Huh? Me and my wife been married 44 years. What about this? This what? Now, this what gets me. Oh, we'll just get married. If it don't work out, we'll get a divorce. Well, what kind of flipping attitude is that? That's like saying, I'll go out for college basketball, and if we don't win, I'll just quit. No. Hold it for a second. Hold your hand there. Coach, does he have a lot of turnovers?
Not really.
Okay, good.
He does have a ring, though. He does have a state championship ring, Coach.
Yeah. Hey.
So he knows what blood looks like.
I love it. Hey, because guys, at the end of the day, you like Kevin, don't you? He picked out that 14 karat gold. But guys, I got to do this and say this, because here's what I've seen in coaching ball players for years and years and years. It's not fair to grandparents to raise kids. And it's not right for a woman to have to raise the kids by herself, or a man to raise the kids by herself. Raising kids together is a thing that's meant for two. Okay? And I've seen way too much of that. And it's time to stop it. It's time to stop it. Oh, we can get an abortion, or we can give the baby away, or we can, no. You knew what you was doing when you did it. So let's man up here. Anybody can father a child, but it takes guts to be a dad. Now, I'm just telling you, like A.C. Green, coach, you know, in the NBA, guy never even had sex. You know, people make fun of him. They make fun of Tebow and all this stuff. But the Lord takes care of him. And here's my point, is you, one of these days, are going to be a dad. You're not going to play basketball forever. And you know who the woman, what the woman does? She takes over your name. She takes over your name. So what kind of name you got? What kind of name you want to make? What if it's your daughter? How do you want to be treated? Now, I'm going to have to get off that soapbox right there. But that's one that really ticks me off. And I preached it for years, all my players. Okay? Because life is what we're teaching them. Life. L-I-F-E. Life. Live in fear every day. Or you can live in faith every day. It's your life. It's your choice. People ask me why I'm successful. Any success I got, because somebody believed in me like a coach to help me. But I said faith in God, belief in myself, courage to continue, spirit to serve, and enjoy enduring to the end. Keep going. Keep going. Life. I love faith, finding answers in the heart. I love that. Hey, come on, the guy, picture this now. Guy standing over here like right here, and there's the Grand Canyon or something, big drop off. And he says, hey, come here, come over here, come over to the edge, come over to the edge. No, if I go over to the edge, I'll fall. No, come on over to the edge. No, if I go to the edge, you know, I'll get hurt. Come on over to the edge. So finally walks over to the edge. And the guy pushes you. And he flies. And that's what happens. Coach, you gotta push you. And he's going to take you somewhere where you might even be afraid to go. You might be afraid to take that step or that leap. But he knows what you can do. He sees it in you already. So when I had those rings, I said, hands, and I said, I'll get to coaching in a minute. Coach, this is a word that came from Denmark in the 1600s. Where they built a wooden box, okay, built a wooden box, and put women and kids in it, and they would help them get through rough areas, terrain, and up hills and valleys, and all that stuff. Now, you watch a Western movie, you're going to see a stagecoach, okay? Everybody know what a stagecoach is, I'm assuming? All right, you ever seen a bus go down the interstate, make on the side of it say coach? Huh? What about sitting in an airplane and it has, are you sitting in first class or are you sitting in coach? A coach is a carrier. They're going to carry you when you can't even carry yourself. They're going to push you when you need push. They're going to pull you and help you when you need that. But they will look in your eyes, look down your heart, look down your soul, and get more out of you than you thought you could ever give. So a coach is a carrier. Now, are you ready for this? The greatest coach you'll ever see is the one in the mirror looking back at me. Back to the responsibility. You looking in that mirror, you can't lie. You can't lie. You gotta talk, you gotta have positive, you gotta have positive self-talk. I get a kick out of players. Pisses me off to no end. Hard on, just for no reason. Coach sitting here trying to pump you up, get you up, get you going. How many times do you want to ride in a car with flat tires? You can't, it's going to wobble, it's going to run. You don't get nowhere. Pump them up like a Reebok commercial. You say, yo, remember the little thing? Pump them up. Pump them up. Say good things. Look for your teammates. I cannot stand to see somebody chewing another player out. Or, man, I made a pass, he cut. Come on, man. Well, come on, man. I go, get him out! When I recruit, I don't sit behind the bench. I sit on the other side so I can see the kid. You don't know what you're getting when everything's going good. You know what you're getting when things are going bad. I'm not just looking. I want to see this kid. What's he doing? What's he going to do? What's he going to do? I don't care if the kid sees me or not. I go sit on the other side. I want to see what he can do. I want to see if that sucker's a champion. Come out of the game. This dog of a team, we played Faulkner, coach, 59-59. I had a kid play the Elite Eight Division One. Big, we didn't make a long story short, we're on the film here, not mentioning any names. Come running off the court. You know why? Because he didn't get back. Why didn't he get back? Because he didn't want to get back. Because he'd been told to get back, rewarded when he got back, brought to his attention when he didn't. See, you don't get in life what you want, you get in life what you reward. And he still just want to do his deal. Well, we ain't got that. He comes out. I said, get him out. Go get him. He come running by me. You know what he's saying on the way by? He's all American, too. He's all American. He go, I ain't got one foul. I wait until he got seated. And I said, and so would the team would hear me. And I said, you can count, but you can't get back. Pretty simple. And he didn't go back in the game. And we got beat. Hell froze over before I put him back in. Because see, here's the deal. If you're not going to be coachable, one of us has got to go. If you're not going to be coachable, one of us has got to go, bruh, because you ain't coachable. Well, that just happens to be my job. You don't know an offense from a defense. You don't know the difference between a technical and a testicle. But you act like you flipping do. You act like you got all the answers because you got an AAU coach. You got a high school coach. You got a junior high coach. And everybody gone. Now you're gone. Now that you're gone, you're great to all of them. They're not going to tell you anything. But God, you can be it all. God, I feel sorry for LeBron. They're going to pump you up, lie to you like ain't no more. My wife still thinks my youngest son's a good ball player. Hey, the only reason he's on our team was because his daddy slept with his mother. I'm the daddy. He thought he was good. Now he could shoot the piss out of him. But he was slow as an 8-titty cow. He was slow as a calendar. Couldn't jump. Played hard. Well, whoop-de do. Whoop-de freaking do. Everybody plays hard. I had to come home. Well, my wife. What's wrong, honey? Well, he was up 20. I don't know why he wouldn't put him in. Oh, baby. I'll be talking to her. See, I'm 76 to this day, she's still like that. So what I'm saying is, I said, okay, here, take this whistle, sweetheart. Come here, cuz. Come here. So you act like you're my wife. I say, now, honey, take his whistle. And you go tomorrow. And make sure you get those big, that 6'8", 330 pounds over there. You make sure you get his hit button gear, too. Understand? And that other 6'6 right there that runs a half mile a minute, 51 seconds, you better make sure he can catch that basketball. Now, I start going through all that, and she says, I don't know why you do that to me. Thank you very much. Give it up for the money. Now, what I want you to know, if I have to leave one message with you, when you mess up, keep going. You get tired, keep going. Okay? Put your head into it. Put your heart into it. And put your hands. You got your hands. And when I think of hands, I think the greatest competitor that ever lived was put to death at 33 years old. Under pressure of hate, he taught love. Pressure of cruelty, he taught mercy. Under pressure of wrongs, he taught right. Under pressure of lies, he taught truth. Jesus Christ won the battle so we could compete. He was the greatest competitor that ever lived. He never even thought a bad thought, never said a bad word, ever. He showed us how to live perfectly. We can get through a day without using profanity. We can get through a day without lying. Not only did he show us how to live, he showed us how to die with dignity and class and finish. Finish strong. Be the very best that you can be. Love the game. Love your coach. Be coachable. And realize that two is greater than one only when they work as one. What if you had five working all together and nobody cares who gets the credit? What if you have 6, 7, 8 and the last man on the bench? Because you'll be, from what I hear, and coach, I don't know, I'm not coaching. I'm just, what I know a little bit, that might be about the only way you're going to win the championship. Because I know you're going to play defense, I know you're going to play offense, but if there's any kind of animosity or some hard feelings or something, it's going to come back and get you. Because when you're a champion, you're not doing it for you. See, now that's responsible, is what you do. But here's what makes you a champion, is accountability. Accountability means you're accountable to them, and they're accountable to you. And it's pretty simple. Life is simple, not easy, but it's pretty simple. Okay? Please and thank you. Be on time. I always said, if you're on time, you're 15 minutes late. And then work your flipping butt off. Desire on fire will get you there. And when everybody else says quit, you can't. I don't know how many people tell me I was too short, I was too dumb, I was too ugly, I was too fat, I was too this, whatever. But I didn't listen to them. I listened to me. In my best self-talk, I listened to me. And I said, they're gonna see how hard I work. They're going to see, I might not be the best ball player, but there's one thing I can do is say, nobody will outwork me. And as far as I know, nobody did. I'd like to know if they thought they did. Even to this day, it pisses me off thinking about it. Because I would work. Now, I think that's what people would say. So, when everyone thinks it's over, quit. Give up, they plead. There's too much against you now, this time you can't succeed. But as you struggle and fight to get back on your feet, you think to yourself and say, this time I won't accept defeat. For everyone goes through trials, some large and some small. It's not what you do to stay on top. It's how you respond when you fall. It's about getting knocked down, but never backing out. Because never giving up is what life is all about. So be brave, stand tall, because the key to life is this, to keep going and rise. time you fall. Thank you, God.